So many of us are so ready for children to get back into the classroom. We can't wait, right? But remember, this is going to be a big transition after almost a year. Some kids will be anxious or depressed as they go back to school. They may not always be vocal about how they're feeling. I spoke with Dr. Asha Patton-Smith, a child and adolescent psychiatrist with Kaiser Permanente, about the changes that parents can make right now to help children adjust to their new schedules and the warning signs to watch for.
It will be time to start the process of transitioning into the face-to-face learning because it's been a while. And so, you know, bedtimes need to be adjusted. The understanding of kind of how the schedule is going to work with 2 or 3 days in person. We also need to understand as parents, caregivers, teachers, administrators, that kids are going to have to adjust to being back. And so giving them that space and that time to do that is extremely important.
Do you have advice for parents about how to support their children through this transition back to school?
Absolutely. I mean, the main thing that I always say to my parents is just take a deep breath. Parents, you do not have to have all the answers. You don't have to know everything, and you can be frustrated. If anything comes out of this pandemic with regard to mental health, it's the understanding that we can be okay with not being okay. But being at a space where they are having very open-ended, non-judgmental conversations with their kids to just see where their kids are at. Because sometimes I think parents assume that kids are feeling a certain way because they are, and that may not indeed be the case, whether it be negative or positive.
I think that you probably need to approach different age children. They have different needs, don't they? Young children, middle schoolers, and high schoolers.
Absolutely. So each stage is a different stage and a different level of learning and a different gift for parents. So they think they figured it out at one stage, and then the next stage happens, and then they become adults, and that's a whole new process.
Yes.
I think with the younger kids, you'll see a lot of regression. They may be more clingy, sometimes crying for no reason, wanting to sleep in a parent or guardian's room. And so just be on the lookout for that. Some of that is natural and normal. Even some kids that had been fully toilet trained may be bedwetting again. So those are things that are common in the age group. Now, the middle schoolers, a lot of times they are very vocal, but sometimes they can have somatic issues like belly pain, headaches, lethargy, or irritability and tantrums that is not really what they typically show in the family environment. And then the older kids, my teenagers are kind of the, I don't know, whatever, why are you asking me?
Right.
That doesn't change, but I do think you need to clue into if they're being more socially isolative or not wanting to talk at all, or kind of the flip side where they're more irritable, more argumentative. I mean, for everyone, it takes about 2 to 3 weeks to really be able to even start to settle in. But if you see an escalation in behaviors, either over that period of time or even sooner where you're like, something's wrong, reach out to your pediatrician, family practitioner, your mental health provider, just to make sure that everything is moving in a positive direction and there are no red or yellow flags that we need to be aware of.
Adjusting to a new schedule can take a few weeks, but as more schools reopen, it's a hopeful sign of progress in our fight against COVID.